talk about drink. Ah, you didn't disappoint me. Now, this week, the government announced they're going to start putting health warning labels on alcoholic drinks. Boo! They'll be telling us we can't drink and drive next. It's shocking. Slippery slope. The safe amount of alcohol to consume is approximately 28 units, which is good news, because that's roughly what I... What's that? A week? Labour Party chairwoman Hazel Bleers is spearheading the campaign. This is the Right Honourable Hazel Bleers. No, it's not. this is Hazel Bleers. Whoa! Hello, pretty lady. She says, as a nation, we actually enjoy getting drunk. You think, well, it's the only way that's getting shagged, isn't it? The government's giving us very confused signals at the moment. I mean, they want us to recycle the bottles, and, you know, we're emptying them as fast as we can. And then we get judged. I am so sick of going to the recycling thing and putting the other thing, and people go, oh, do you have a party? No. Me. I drank that last night. The statistics are interesting. According to a news agency, Reuters, one in four Britons binge drink so much they wake up the next morning and don't know what they've done. One in four. Oh, what a semi-final that will be. Let's get some guests on. He's a phantom with a gigantic organ. Please welcome musical genius Andrew Lloyd Webber.
Hello there.
It looks like two of your heads shoved down that top, doesn't it? Anyway, no, just talking about drinking, as we were, I would say, I think one of the best pubs I ever was in was the one in that village in Ireland where in
Fethard,
Yes,
Fethard, County Tipperary.
Because it's not just a pub.
It's an undertaker.
The bodies aren't in the pub, though, are they?
I think what happens is that Annette, who runs the bar, then leaves a slate there, so that you just honesty bar, and then she buries the body quite nearby. It's only opposite, you see.
Yes, it's handy.
Used to have a hotel there, but they've closed that.
Oh,
because you could have actually gone, you see, from the hotel to the bar to the grave and never have left the building.
Are you a big party animal?
No, I don't get invited to parties.
No.
I don't. No, don't feel any sympathy. I think about the last party I got invited to, I was about 15 years old, and I had a group. There was a group of friends at school who were very cool. You know, the cool people that look good and do cool things. And I was invited to a party, and I just remember that there was a room full of people, and they're all sort of shagging and getting off with each other on the couch, about 15, and smoking spliffs and drinking, and in the darkness. And then I rushed in and turned the lights on and went, guys, you have got to see this. And I put on a video, and it was Charlie Chaplin. Now, to me, that was the most astounding thing, Charlie Chaplin in modern times, which to me is the most beautiful, hilarious, wonderful, poetic thing I'd ever seen. But people who are sort of kissing women aren't very interested in it. So it was a bit sad, really.
Even when you were in the National Youth Theatre and everything, did you not get into crazy...
Even when I was in the National Youth Theatre, you're insinuating that I was unprofessional. No, I'm a lightweight. I eat. I'm a Jew. Jews don't really drink. We eat. You wouldn't know it to look at me, Graham,
no.
But as a child, I used to eat.
You carry it well.
Yes, thank you very much.
Now, you're both married men. Yes?
Sort of. I wouldn't call what I've got marriage. That would be endorsing it.
Do you know, I was one of the very few people in the House of Lords when I was there, and I'm sorry to drop that, but I voted for...
I think we know you're a lord by now.
No, thanks to you, but I got into real trouble because I voted in favour of gay adoption of children.
Well, it's morally wrong, and I don't agree.
No, I'm joking.
You signed by Simon Cowell.
Yes, I did. I'm joking.
What next am I getting on the show for?
No, I'm joking.
Now, I know what everybody thinks about this, but I think it's a very serious point. I think that there are some wonderful gay couples, and I hope you have a wonderful, wonderful marriage.
You're very kind, thank you.
Yes. But now, just to talk about marriage...
Sorry, it's a serious point on this programme.
No, I know, it'll still be cut out, but anyway.
I know it will. even further outtakes.
Yes. But actually, I'll tell you an interesting thing, because I don't want to become this sort of... spokesman, you know, I'm more about just being a twat in a dress, but the truth is people kind of go, oh, you know, when two men, or, you know, or two women, when they have a civil partnership, you're sort of making a mockery of marriage, or you're looking to, you know, somehow ape, you know, the institution of marriage. But actually, firstly, you know, me and Kevin, we love each other. And, you know, that is the reason to do it. But also, it just means that you have the same legal rights as people who are married. So that's a great thing. And then, who knows, maybe we will adopt. Who knows?
Yeah.
Maybe we'll adopt another gay or something. I don't know. I don't know. We'll adopt players. Yeah.
Yeah. Do you have him in the house?
No, not in the house.
No. I'll be off campus. Yes. Yeah. Yes.
But not about you, Graham. Would you get married? Would you tie the knot? Because some gay people don't agree with the idea of civil partnership. And it's called civil partnership as a concession to some people in the House of Lords, I believe, and in the Commons.
Really?
Because
Ooh.
If you called it marriage... You see, it's not marriage because you can't mention God in the ceremony. So you can't even go, oh, God, what am I doing?
You can't. No.
No.
You'd be breaking the law.
Why yes. not? Well, I don't know. It's a concession to the church, I guess. But I'm Jewish. Who gives a shit?
In terms of getting married and yes. keeping a happy marriage, I don't know if you saw this in the paper, but they're reissuing this book, right? And it's, one's called Don'ts for Wives, one's called Don'ts for Husbands. It was originally published in 1913, and they're bringing it out again, and I think it's going to be a big bestseller. So, and actually, some of it is quite good. Like, Don'ts for Wives, don't say, I told you so to your husband, however much you feel tempted to. It does no good. And he will be grateful to you for not saying it. It's good kind of ordinary workaday advice. Don't omit to pay your husband a compliment. If he looks nice dressed for the opera, tell him so. That's so your world. If he has been successful with his chickens or his garden, compliment him.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah. Do you have a recipe for a happy marriage, sir?
Yes, I do. Having been through three...
I know, you ought to know by now.
I ought to.
Yes.
And having one for 17 years, and it's a very simple and very corny word, but it's love.
Aww.
If we could only remember that love changes everything and is so important...
Oh, he's pushing one of his own songs here. Hello.
It's just about to go on tour, Aspen.
Yeah,
exactly. Try and get a plug in.
Oh, actually, let's see how many other song titles he tries to get into these.
Oh, I can do a few.
I know, he's so good.
Yes.
Oh, well,
I've just lost my memory.
Yeah.
Oh, memory.
Memory, yes. Yes, memory.
Right there.
There we go.
Very good.
I'm too busy thinking. I've got heaven on my mind, so I can't think of a song.
Goodness. Yes. Everything's all right, though.
Everything's all right. Everything's fine.
I'm not upset. Don't you cry for me, Argentina.
And no.
Okay, that wasn't so subtle.
That's for you. You're a superstar.
Oh, Jesus Christ. You know the whole idea of doing Joseph and being on a telly event? Do you think you will do Jesus Christ Superstar? Because looking for Jesus is such a kind of gift of a...
It's a wonderful headline, isn't it?
It really is.
Yeah, but you'll have David Ian going, we're looking for a modern Jesus, a thoroughly modern Christ.
We won't have David Ian doing
it. No, you won't have David Ian.
But Jesus, do you think it will happen?
I don't know. I've got to write another show soon, otherwise I'll go mad. I mean, I'm going to do the Phantom sequel. I've decided I'm going to do that now. And that'll be... You know, it's going to take me a year to do that, minimum.
Wow. And in terms of looking for Jesus, we thought, right, we could get a little head start. A head start on the Jesus auditions, OK? So in our activity room backstage, we have a lineup of aspiring Jesuses. Perhaps that's G's eye. I don't know. So, Let's go over and check them out. Oh, by the way, I've got a buzzer here, so we can just basically it's a Jesus gong show. Is
right,
what we've
okay.
got.
So,
Jesus number one, please. Various talents. Oh, look, it's the Holy Land, everyone.
Not Jesus.
Oh, look, juggling Jesus.
Very good.
It was good. It was good.
Don't lie.
That's unfair.
Oh, oh!
Who are you?
I is Jesus, innit?
No, I am Jesus.
What, you is Jesus too?
Yes, I am Jesus too.
This is Planet of the Apes!
That's good.
It was good.
Opportunity for a
duet
that
yes.
we didn't have.
Oh, 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 oh,
Starlight Express.
Starlight Express.
Starlight Express.
Oh, yes.
Very good.
Oh, now we're talking.
I'd just like to point out that this balloon crown of thorns that
I'm wearing. Oh, he's got a balloon crown of thorns.
Probably
that's genius.
The most comfortable piece of, oh my goodness, of balloon,
he's making something.
Of balloon headgear. That I have ever created.
Possibly so a balloon crucifix.
All of you.
We can't be sure.
America, it's even here about that balloon squeaking, that horrendous balloon squeaking. But if I can get a little bit of inspiration from the beautiful Bethlehem scene behind me.
Oh!
And, I think over here we have a...
we love this, we must move on. Right. That was very good, though. Excellent. Excellent. Oh, oh! Is that a man or woman, Jesus? That's quite good. Hurry up, get another one up there.
It's sexy. This Jesus has been sent to tease us.
I think we get it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Take your hoop. His street credibility is very low now. Oh, hello.
Hello. Or halo.
That was very poor.
I think what this proves beyond any doubt is the deep respect people hold for your work.
Oh, hang on. Who are you? Or is this dancing? Should we send in St. John's ambulance? Very good. Okay. Which Jesus did we prefer? The Roller Skates didn't do anything.
I think the last one was very good. I think he taught us something.
Yes?
We have to learn something from these programmes. And that is... I never knew that Jesus wore black knickers.
No.
It's been educational.
Yes. Thank you. All right, so...
Thank you, Graham.
Should we say breakdancing Jesus is our Jesus?
Well done, breakdancing Jesus. Very good.
OK, we're going on to animal news. Ooh. Animal news. There's no actual link, but there is. So, now, here's a picture. This is a picture from a successful American hunting trip. There he is. this boy, his name is Jameson Stone.
Who's he?
And you do sort of think middle name 18. he's big for 11. That is a big kid. And he's looking at him, two slices of bread. Jameson pursued that boar through the woods for over 3 hours. which you kind of think is not bad for a fat kid running through woods for 3 hours. Apparently, he shot it 7 times before finishing it off with a shot to the head. Aw, kids.
They do the darndest things, don't they?
7 times in the head. Oh, you. Now, listen, before you pass judgment, ladies and gentlemen, there is a reason why these animals are hunted. According to the Daily Mail, they're hunted to stop the damage they do to forests. Okay? The article continues, several trees were cut down to pull the hog out of the forest. Nice work, Jameson. Now, the boys' family, this is they've set up a website, right, to basically hurrah for killing a big pig, and invited people to place comments. They've done, basically, you can do positive comments, or you do negative comments, right? Obviously. Negative comments, read them here.
Well, it's that computer as well, oh, cool.
No. warning, your negative emails may be posted, and some of you will be prayed for. So, like, some of them are, you know, animal lovers, people animal. So somebody's written, love the animals. God has given them the rudiments of thought and joy untroubled. Fair enough. Some animal people, not quite so thoughtful. What the f*** is your f*** problem, you fat ass bitch? You f*** killed a f*** innocent little pig. They might be prayed for. I feel. Jameson claims to have shot America's biggest boar, but not yet, you haven't. What? Now, talking about animals, have you heard about his cat? Not the famous singing ones.
Not Elaine Page. Would you keep her in your house?
This cat, when did you get the cat?
I got the cat about 3 months ago.
And tell us what makes the cat special?
He swims, because he's a Turkish swimming cat. They're called Turkish Vans, and they come from a place called Lake Van. And if you don't believe me, I'm sure we've got something we can prove it.
Oh, actually, I do. Yeah. I've got, this is a
very fine magazine
all about these cats.
Called Vantasia, and I'll take the cover off. There's a cat swimming. Okay.
Oh, hand over, cat. Hand over. No, move hand. Yeah. Hand.
Yes, yes.
There you go. Now, is that cat swimming or drowning?
There's a picture of him on top of a dog as well. He likes swimming at all times. That is a relation of my cat, who's called Otto. And he's absolutely the most wonderful cat I've had in the many years I've had of owning pussies. So it's, nearly 60 years of those.
And the kitten, I mean, how old is he now? Is he 3 months old?
He's about 6 months now.
Six months old.
He's huge.
And he chooses to just jump in the swimming pool.
What he does at the moment is to paddle about. He hasn't yet dived in.
All right, you don't just chuck him. I'd be impatient to see him swimming.
I'd be a bore, wouldn't I? No, I wouldn't do that to him. But he will. He's absolutely extraordinary. But he's such fun. Yesterday, okay, I'm trying to write some new music. He gets inside the grand piano. He likes the way that it works. And he's worked out, of course, that the keyboard works to the keys, okay? Next door to it, I got a piano that I can record on, which is basically a computer. So he jumps from the piano onto the computer, destroys the entire score of the new Phantom in one fell swoop. Brilliant cat.
He's not a fan, then.
No, he's a van.
He's a van, yes.
Yeah, imagine he's a corpse.
Look at my little cat. Look, that's him. Look at him.
No, that's not him. That's a picture of him.
I was getting too frightened.
Let's have a look.
Yeah. Nice. Note the huge paws. They have very big paws.
For swimming.
You know what they say, big paws.
Well, let's see. I haven't seen
Where's your dog?
They're upstairs, shitting and pissing.
Look at that face, though.
Gorgeous.
Swimming away there. Look at it.
Now, do you need a swimming pool?
It's a cat. I mean, what? It's a cat.
It's swimming.
It's a swimming cat, then.
You need probably 2 or 3 pools, because a cat will obviously want an indoor pool, because it's obviously going to be cold in the winter, and then a proper huge outdoor pool for the summer.
And a jacuzzi, darling. A wonderful jacuzzi with a bubble.
with a pause button.
Yes. Yes. A jacuzzi.
Of course it's got to have a jacuzzi.
A bidet.
That is a serious issue. Because the bidet in my bathroom, he gets into all the time.
Really?
Mm. Yes.
Who left all these hairs in the bidet?
Oh, I mean, that's a plug for another musical.
Hair?
Yes. Exactly.
There you go. B-Day the musical.
Now, you just did one of your voices then. And I've been very good, I thought. I didn't poke you with a stick and make you do any voices. But do people, are you like a kind of a human jukebox? Do people just come up to you all the time and kind of go, oh, do a bit of? Or do they just do them to you?
No, they just come up and go, oh, your art, we never miss. Go on, we love, we do Am I Bothered. Go on. Go on, garlic bread. We all love it. Well, no one ever likes you. It's always their friend. My daughter. I've never seen it. I don't watch it. My daughter. We hate it. My daughter. I've got a gun here. I'm going to shoot you. No one likes you. Do you know what I mean? When people ask for an autograph, it's never for them.
But it is incredible, the success of it. Like, all the merchandising. Here's the lovely, the lovely dolls.
Can I have one of those?
Yeah, of course you can.
Thank you.
Yeah. Is that you? I mean, did you do...
No, that's a doll, but... that is my voice, I think, yeah. Well, it is, yeah, it is.
And look, and they've... It is very...
No, don't, no.
What are you saying, no, don't?
No, because... No, that is rude.
This one doesn't have the merkin that you have in the show.
There's a merkin. In fact, we for hours, because originally when I came out as Bubbles, she was bald, and I really liked that. But David was like, no, that is grotesque. I was like, yeah, but no. So he helped them cut a merkin to put the stick on.
David insisted on the
merkin. Yeah, he was absolutely. And I thought, I thought you
got more before.
Yes. I thought he's got more experience of that sort of area, so I let him go with it. Yeah, this is
lovely.
Yeah, I'm a bit worried about how you're attached you're getting to it.
This is sweet. Nice hands.
What about a nice doll of you? Little dolls of you and Tim Rice. That would be nice. That would be